Welcome to this presentation about achievable stability in redundancy systems. My name is Juri Rijmakers. I'm from Eindhoven University of Technology, and this is joint work with Sam Bost. First, I will tell what redundancy systems are, and then I will focus more on the stability question. So consider parallel server systems. So here you can see three servers, each with their own queue. And now upon arrival, the question is to which server we should send this job. And this question is studied in a lot of papers. And there are policies such as join the shortest workload or join the shortest queue. However, in redundancy, this job is replicated. So we see that here the job is replicated onto two replicas. And then these two replicas are allocated to the servers uniformly at random without replacement. So here we see that the two blue replicas go to the top two servers, and they go immediately into servers because these servers were idle. So another arrival, again, replication, allocation, and going into servers if possible. So hopefully by this example, the process upon arrival is clear and we can now focus on the departure process. In redundancy systems, it is assumed that the job, so for example here, the blue job, is completed as soon as one of the replicas finishes servers. So assume now that the top server finished the service of the blue replica, then the other blue replicas are abandoned from the system. So here you can see that the blue replica at the middle server is abandoned from the system. So in the next snapshot, you will see that the green replica goes into servers at the top server, and the red replica goes into servers at the middle server. So that's what you see here. Now observe that within redundancy, it might happen, and that's also what you see here, that multiple replicas of the same job are in servers simultaneously. And it may even happen that these replicas have different starting times. Because for example, here you can see that the bottom server is already working on a green replica. Well, when the blue job departs, then the top server is serving the green replica. So they started at different times. So now we focus more on the stability condition and with the first come first served service discipline, the service discipline that you also saw in the visualization. And I think it's fair to say that the stability condition isn't in general hard due to the possibility concurrent servers of several replicas. However, there are two special cases for which the stability condition is known. The first case is exponential job size and IID replicas, heterogeneous servers, and the stability condition is then given by the equation on this fourth bullet point. And actually, this is the stability condition for homogeneous servers to make it slightly easier. So we see that rho, which is defined at the arrival as the arrival rate times the expected job size divided by the number of servers, should be less than one for the system to be stable. Also note that this stability condition does not depend on D and is actually therefore the same for having no replication or, for example, full replication. The other scenario for which the stability condition is known is for the distribution that is scaled Bernoulli. So there the job size is either zero or K with some probability. And again, for IID replicas and homogeneous servers, the stability is known and is given in this fourth bullet point. Observe here that there is a term rho times the number of servers. However, the definition of rho, which you can see on the left-hand side, there's a division by capital N. So actually in the right-hand side, the stability condition does not depend on the number of servers. So we have that for exponential job sizes, it depends on the number of servers, but not on the number of replicas. Well, for scaled Bernoulli job sizes, it depends on the number of replicas, but not on the number of servers. So this is sort of a contrast between those two stability conditions. So now moving to what we will tell in this talk. In this talk, we assume general job sizes, either identical or IID replicas, and type-dependent server speeds. So this is more general than the heterogeneous servers assumed in the last slide. However, this of course comes with a cost. We're not able to derive exact stability, the exact stability condition, but we will give a comparison argument. So basically answering the question, should we replicate or not? So to set the model a little bit more clear, assume server speeds divided by capital R, and these are different for every server. And we assume that these are discrete. So we get that Rij is the server speed for type J job on server I. And the job sizes, as already seen on the previous slide, are denoted by capital X and can be different for every replica. Okay, so in this model, the runtime of a job is then X over the server speeds. And we allow for static probabilistic allocation of replicas to the servers. And this might depend on the job type. Okay, to give a little bit more intuition about this whole model, I have this fast-slow scenario in which we assume to have two servers, two job types, and the job type 1 has server speeds 1 and 0.5 on server 1 and 2, and the job type 2 has server speeds 0.5 and 1 on servers 1 and 2. Basically saying that job type 1 is fast on server 1 and slow on server 2, and a job of type 2 is slow on server 1 and fast on server 2. And these job types occur with equal probability. Okay, so note that in this scenario, the optimal allocation in case of D is 1, when you know the job types, is given that you just send the job that is fast, for example, on server 1 to server 1, and the jobs that are fast on server 2 to server 2. Okay, so now we come to the actual results of the paper and of this presentation. And we see that, for example, in the scenario of known job types and IID replicas, no replication gives the largest stability region in case the job size distribution is new better than used. And the definition of new better than used, I will give this definition on the next slide. But if the job types are unknown, then we see actually that full replication gives the largest stability region if the job types are new worse than used. Okay, so these are the results, and all the other scenarios, so for example, if you are in the case with known job types, IID replicas, which are new worse than used, these the stability region actually, the large stability region depends on the server speeds. Okay, and in the remaining of this talk, I will go into detail in this scenario. So IID replicas, new better than used, and known job types. Before looking at the theorem, I will give the definition of new better than used and new worse than used. And this definition is in terms of the complementary cumulative distribution function, the CCDF, which is defined as 1 minus the cumulative distribution function. And you see that for new better than used, we have this inequality with here a smaller than or equal to sign. Well, for new worse than used, we have this inequality. So basically the sign here is reversed. And to give even some more intuition, new better than used are distributions that have low variability, while new worse than used are distributions that have high variability. So for example, new better than used, it's deterministic or a viable distribution with shape parameter k greater or equal than 1. Well, new worse than used, you can think, for example, on Pareto distribution or the viable distribution with shape parameter k less or equal than 1. And of course, there are many more. And note that the exponential distribution is both new better than used and new worse than used. Okay, so now to the one of the main theorems of the paper, which states that no replication is best for new better than used job sizes. And actually, yeah, it's better than every other number of replications. And what we will do next is to prove this statement for a slightly simplistic, slightly simpler scenario of homogeneous servers and same starting times. So now if you calculate the expected runtime with D replicas, we see that they all start at the same time. So it's simply the expectation of the minimum of all the job sizes stated here. And this expectation of the minimum, we can write this in this integral equation, in this into this integral. Now note that we can use the definition of new better than used, which is stated on the bottom of the slide, to rewrite this in into this integral. And this integral with some substitution of variables is equal to 1 over d times the expectation of the job size. So for same starting times and homogeneous servers, we can derive this this equation. But note that if we have D replicas, they occupy D servers. So actually, if you want to calculate the server capacity by these D replicas, we have to multiply this equation by D, which you see here. And now we get that this is greater or equal than just the expectation of X. And note that this right-hand side is exactly equal to the server capacity for just having D is 1, just having 1 replica for every job. So with this statement, we proved that the stability region for D is 1 is larger than the stability region for D greater than 1 if you assume homogeneous servers and same starting times. And of course, in the redundancy system, this is not necessarily true, as we already saw in the beginning of this talk. And in the paper, we extend this proof to type-dependent server speeds and arbitrary starting times. But this was just a little bit too complicated to tell in this presentation. So if you really want to see the proof, then I refer to the full paper. Okay, so we already saw that no replication was best for MBU, but it can actually also be that full replication may be best for new better than used job size distributions. And in this, we have to assume that we cannot observe the job types. So if we cannot observe the job types, it might even be the case that full replication is best for new better than used. So we again consider the example of fast and slow server speeds. So here we have two servers and two job types. And now we have a slightly general, slightly more general example with one and X is the and X and one of the different server speeds of the different job types. And again, equal probability of the job types occurring. So note that this is without observing the job types, this is a symmetric scenario. So basically the best allocation for D equal to one is just to send half of the jobs to server one and half of the jobs to server two. So if we use this, we get the following stability conditions. And we will look a bit more into these stability conditions. For example, when the X here goes to zero. So if you look at this term, if the X goes to zero, then this is just simply the expectation of X. Well, if you look at this term, whenever X goes to zero, then we see that this term actually becomes infinity. So here we see that for X going to zero, the stability region for DS2 is larger than the stability region for DS1. There is also a scenario for which is the other way around. So here, when we set X equal to one, then we see that this minimum simply becomes the expectation of the minimum, and that this term equals half times the expectation of X. And we already saw in the previous slide that we have for MBU distributions, we have a formula for this term, and this is greater or equal than half times the expectation of X, meaning that for X equal to one, the stability region for D equal to one is larger than the stability region for D equal to two. So we saw that for unbalanced server speeds, full replication is best even for MBU distributed job sizes, and that for balanced server speeds, D equal to one gives the largest stability region. And with this, I would like to conclude this presentation. Thank you for your attention. And if you're interested, I refer to the full paper for all the results. Thank you.